Welcome to a special ASX Schools Share Market Game podcast. My name is Theresa Lindfeld. I'm the Senior Manager Brand and Content at ASX, and I'm also responsible for the Share Market Game. In this podcast, we review new learning materials educators can use to teach students the important life skill of investing.
A quick note about this podcast. Information is provided for educational purposes only and is not intended to include or constitute financial product advice. You should obtain independent advice from an Australian Financial Services licensee before making any investment decisions. Please refer to the ASX's full disclaimer with respect to this podcast on the School Share Market Game Teacher Resources page on the ASX website.
I'm delighted to welcome Rosette Kerr today to our podcast. Now, I met Rosette a couple of months ago. We got her into the office to really start looking at some of the lessons we've got for the school share market game. And she's been working really hard to update those. And I think, you know, what really impressed me when I met Rosette for the first time was her passion about investing. And so she told me a story about how her whole family jumps up in front of the telly every time an economist comes up and talks about the day and the markets and everything that's happened. So Rosette is an award-winning teacher. She's obviously developed some fantastic new learning materials for us, and we'll talk about those today. And to give you some background on Rosette, she's an educator. She's been teaching financial literacy and students how to invest for over 10 years in the classroom and as head of a department at a school. And before teaching, she actually worked in corporate banking and in the legal field for over a decade. So currently, she's the head of teaching and learning at her school in Sydney. She runs numerous teacher training courses dealing specifically around assessment, literacy, creative and independent project-based learning for teachers as a director of the Professional Association for Teachers in her subject areas in New South Wales. She's won several awards, including the Western Sydney Women Educator of the Year for 2022 and the 2022 Crescent Wealth Educator of the Year for Innovation in Teaching for her work in improving financial literacy for young people. So welcome to our program, Rosette, and thank you so much for all the fantastic work you've done on the teaching materials. I'm really looking forward to getting feedback from our teachers on the new materials.
Thank you, Theresa. Thank you for inviting me, and thank you for allowing me to assist your organisation.
So you've been working with students and teaching the share market game for quite a while. So tell me about your association with the ASX share market game.
So I've been using the ASX share market game for at least 10 years at my school. I really enjoy teaching students how to invest. I'm deeply passionate about it. And I feel like the ASX share market is an integral part of it. My association with the ASX actually began in the classroom as a 14-year-old when I learned how to share, invest using newspapers. It was really life-changing for me. I just found it, you know, so exciting. Using what I learned, I began investing in the share market as a young adult and an avid investor ever since. For over 10 years, I've been using the ASX Schools Share Market Game in my classroom to teach students how to invest in shares, and they too love it.
That's fantastic. And, you know, obviously got your family involved in all of that.
Absolutely.
As well. So tell me, why do you choose to use the ASX Share Market Game at your school and in your classroom?
I feel like learning how to invest is an integral part of financial literacy, and it's relatively easy to do once students understand the basics, which definitely the lessons and the resources that we've created really help with. So in my experience, the ASX Schools Share Market Game is really interactive, and that's the reason why students really love it. It's a realistic platform. It, you know, allows educators to really teach an essential life skill. My students love playing it and walk away with a skill they can use to make wise investment decisions in the future. In the past, I've accessed the free resources such as posters to advertise to students that the ASX game is about to begin. And we've also held competitions at our school, which sees our students compete with one another within the school environment. And usually the winner walks away with a trophy at the end of the competition. And the great thing about the ASX share market game is that it's so realistic and that it's in real time, with students having access to real company data without any risk whatsoever. What I especially love is that students that might not be fully engaged in learning often find themselves achieving some really amazing results, which can be quite life-changing in how they perceive themselves. It's not necessarily the most academic student that achieves the best result. It's usually the ones that do the best research and use the analytical decision-making skills that outperform their peers. I had one student last year who was in the top 10 students for New South Wales at one point in the game, which was really so exciting and motivating for him to learn about investing and financial literacy in general. The way I use it in my classroom is we usually start the lesson with myself showing the school leaderboard onto the projector in the class. Then we do our learning, so we integrate the lessons into what I'm teaching for the day, and then I give the students about 10 minutes and it's a bit of a reward, and they get to do all their share trades and talk to their peers about what trades they're doing and what they think will do well. So the students in my class really look forward to playing the game, and there's definitely a lot of healthy competition there in terms of who's at the top of the leaderboard at the very end.
That's fantastic. It's so interesting, you know, how the students are engaged, and also how our educators are really truly amazing with the level of skill they have and what they need to consider when developing lessons. Now, it sounds like the resources that you've developed have made it really easier for them to teach how to invest. So tell me a little bit about the work with the ASX over the last several months and how you approached developing the new materials.
So I've been working on creating learning materials that make it easier for educators to teach students the important life skill of share trading. As you know, teachers are incredibly time poor and they don't always have time to create innovative, relevant or engaging lessons for students. And they really need to think about embedding the skills and capabilities that are within the curriculum. There's really a lot to teaching and it's not as simple as what most people think. I've created 10 easy to follow lessons that are curriculum mapped and are relevant to how and what we teach in the classroom. The resources are linked to several subjects Australia-wide, to general capabilities and to cross-curriculum areas that teach students how to invest, with a glossary that explains the meta language used in investing. So it's easy for educators to be able to see the links to their subject areas, saving them a lot of planning time. It's just a matter of using the lessons in the classroom. And all the lessons are really easy to modify. So if a teacher wants to add a question or remove an activity, they can do it really easily. It also means that it's easy for teachers to load it up onto the school's learning platform, such as Canvas or Google Classroom.
Fantastic. So the lessons are easy to use and are easily understood by students. Is that right?
Yes, absolutely. We've made it easy for students from about ages 10 upwards across a wide range of abilities. From those students who are on life skills with some modification by the teacher to those who are gifted and talented. This is because the activities are based on skills and use directives that are drawn from the Australian and state-based curriculums, making them compatible with how and what teachers teach. The lessons use questioning that allows students of a wide level of ability to engage with them by completing the easy-to-read and understand content, and then test their knowledge by completing the set activities. What we've made sure of is that the explanations are formal, so they're easy to understand in language that's quite simple. I think a lot of people assume that a casual language style is easy to understand, but that's not the case. It's very important that teachers expose students to formal language and to formal writing styles to get them ready for the workplace. Every teacher is a literacy teacher after all, and it's our job to make sure that student literacy improves. There's several types of directives used in each of the lessons, with a variety of activity types across the series of lessons. All the directive verbs are on the actual worksheet, along with the glossary meta language relevant to that lesson, so students fully comprehend what they need to. All of the lessons allow for learner literacy development, with links to other capabilities that are in the Australian curriculum, such as numeracy, information and communication technology, critical and creative thinking, personal and social capabilities, ethical understanding, and intercultural understanding, depending on the lesson. You'll also notice that the actual content, while quite thorough in teaching students how to invest, are also relevant to how and what we teach in the classroom. For example, Lesson 1 and 2 explicitly teach the features of different business legal structures, which is something that's taught across many subject areas in both Stage 5 and 6. These resources are made by a teacher for teachers, which I think is really, really important.
Fantastic. It's so interesting. I never realized how three-dimensional the requirements are within a classroom. It's not just about investing. It's all about those other aspects as well. And our educators are really amazing in terms of the level of skill they have and what they need to consider when developing the lessons. So it sounds like all of these resources make it really a lot easier for them to teach how to invest as well. Tell me about the ethical and the intercultural understanding aspects of the lessons. When can we expect to see these?
So working through the series, you'll come to the ethical and intercultural understanding aspects in lessons 9 and 10. So lesson 9 explores ethical understanding through the topic of environmental social governance, so ESG for short, in relation to the ASX and the companies that are listed on the ASX. So ESG is a term used to describe a company's commitment to ensure that they contribute positively to the world. ESG goes beyond legal requirements, ensuring transparency, ethical actions, and social justice. It is incredibly important when it comes to a business's long-term success and to our global community. So it's essential that students are able to explore this important aspect so they can make wise ethical decisions. And of course, some of the students that play the ASX schools share market game are the business leaders of the future. So it's important they recognise the importance of ESG.
Fantastic. You also mentioned Lesson 10 and, you know, we worked quite closely on Lesson 10 and had quite a few discussions about it. Tell us more about Lesson 10 and where that fits in.
So Lesson 10 is the one that I enjoyed producing the most because of its recognition of not only the environment and the importance of companies looking after it with their actions, but also the involvement of Indigenous leaders in the business world. Specifically, I had the privilege of interviewing Brad Welsh. So he's the Managing Director and Chief Executive of Energy Resources of Australia Limited, so ERA for short, which is a company where the majority stake is held by Rio Tinto, which is one of the largest companies listed on the ASX. I was completely inspired by his story and his work, and I think a lot of educators and students will also feel inspired. And I enjoy learning about the important role played by Indigenous business leaders who are at the forefront of successful companies listed on the ASX. I also really like this lesson because it allows for lots of different subject areas across all of Australia, either as a standalone or part of their learning how to invest in the ASX. This lesson and the share market overall obviously has strong links to economics and business as part of the Australian curriculum or commerce in New South Wales. But this lesson also links to subjects such as English and geography, which are traditionally not associated with financial literacy. So I really hope that teachers use these lessons especially.
Yeah, I'm very pleased that we've been able to include that in the lesson plans. So finally, I noticed that there's an assessment task included as part of the learning materials produced to complement the ASX school share market game. It's quite a thorough assessment. What can you tell me about it?
So teachers find assessment writing one of the most challenging aspects of the job. And we've done all the work for teachers when it comes to teaching students about investing in the share market. And that includes the assessment task with all the elements needed to allow for a high level of student engagement and development of skills while still being compliant with curriculum requirements. If you have a look at the assessment, it's made up of three distinct sections with three different activities that consolidate what they have learned in the lesson. Again, they have skill directives embedded into the assessment, and the language is easy to understand while still maintaining that formality. The best match for the assessment task is Stage 4 or Stage 5 Economics or Business, or in New South Wales to Commerce. But it can be easily modified to suit any other subject areas. Instructions in red allow teachers to understand what can be deleted, what needs to be inserted, such as course outcomes, due dates, the school emblem, instructions on submission to ensure that they're curriculum compliant. but the rubrics, which are often the most time-consuming and difficult elements of creating an assessment task, are included and are quite thorough and can easily be modified.
Fantastic. I remember, you know, throughout the process of development that ease of modification was one of the most important features of lessons that we discussed.
Absolutely. It also means that teachers can really take into account the abilities and learning needs of their students. For example, for younger students, a teacher might decide to keep only section one, which looks at keeping track of the performance of a company of interest for that student. They are then able to input the data into the spreadsheet associated with the assessment, and this section allows for students to visually see the performance because it generates a graph automatically. It's very exciting for students to see that, and it allows them to make better critical decisions when investing and also get used to looking at graphs and understanding graphs. What I really like about this assessment also is it allows for students to independently develop their research skills in the second section. Or in the third section, they have voice and choice as to how they demonstrate their learning with higher order thinking tasks. So the assessment can be modified to meet the learning needs of all students and all schools. And again, it's easy for teachers to upload them onto the school's learning platform. I think this assessment will be very popular with teachers.
Thank you for meeting with us today, Rosette. It's certainly been enlightening. I love the way you've made it so easy for teachers to incorporate the ASX share market game into their schools and into their classrooms. And I hope that it benefits them and it benefits their students and it gets more and more people playing the ASX share market game. And I want to thank you on behalf of all of the thousands of teachers and students all across Australia for creating a suite of engaging and relevant learning resources that will improve the financial literacy of young people and hopefully get them investing early in life and building their wealth.
Thank you so much, Teresa. Thank you for having me and for allowing me to share my passion for financial literacy and specifically share investing with teachers and students all over Australia. I thank you for allowing me to make a difference, just like that teacher who taught me this life-changing skill as a 14-year-old many decades ago. Thank you.
Thanks, Rosette.
Want to test market strategies? Sign up to participate in the ASX share market game and receive $50,000 in virtual cash to invest in a range of stocks and ETFs. Visit asx.com.au/smg to register today.